What is up, YouTube? It is Coach Cory, and in today's video, I'm going to rank all the brawlers for Brawl Ball. I'll rank them from 1 to 18. I'll tell you who's the best, and I'll tell you why. And then also, after that, I'll go over each map and tell you who is the best on each specific Brawl Ball map. Okay, really quick, I just want to give a shout-out to Jeffrey Neo Smith and Rusty, aka PJ, for helping me make this ranking video. Okay, so to start out, let's go over the top three brawlers for Brawl Ball, and that is, in order, Mortis at 1, and then Shelly at 2, and El Primo at 3. I almost said 4. At 3. Mortis is, in my opinion, the best brawler in Brawl Ball, specifically because of his dash, basically solely based on his offensive capability. Since it's just the first to 2 goals, the ability to score goals is very important in Brawl Ball. Now, all of these top 3 brawlers have high offensive capability, specifically Mortis and El Primo. Whatever team composition you're using, I would want to have at least one Mortis or one El Primo. You could use both, but you'd want at least one of them in your team comp. You could maybe use Bull. You'll see where he's ranked later, but I don't think he's quite as good. Mortis by himself can dash and attack. If you tap right away, you can get the ball back right away. He's able to go up the map very quickly. He can run by opponents, and he can easily score by himself. He's a very good distraction. He can hold on to the ball for a long time, making it hard for the enemy to score as well. He's just overall very strong in Brawl Ball. Now, Shelly is also very strong in Brawl Ball, specifically because there are so many boxes, for one, so it makes her super very useful. And then also, there's a lot of high health brawlers like El Primo, like Mortis, who's not very high health, but Shelly's very good versus Mortis. Bull is also in there a lot. So Shelly is very strong. Shelly's probably one of the stronger defensive brawlers, one of the best support brawlers in Brawl Ball, with her ability to clear boxes and then able to deal a lot of damage at close range. Now, El Primo is number 3, specifically for his offensive capability. He can score a lot of goals by himself. One of the best tactics with El Primo is to shoot the ball forward and then jump on top of the ball. Now, often this is great when you're sort of in the middle of the field and you can shoot it towards the front of the goal, and then you can knock away any enemies who are near the ball, and then you can typically have a free lane to score. He's very good offensively. He can do stuff like that a lot. He's also able to stop stuff defensively if they're getting close to him as well. Now let's go into our other brawlers. Going on, so from 4 to 13, these are all the brawlers that I think are still usable in Brawl Ball. After that, they're not going to be very usable. But let's start at the top. Starting at 4, at Tara. Tara is very similar to Shelly in that she's a good support brawler. She can deal a decent amount to a good amount of damage at close to long range. And her super is also very good defensively. She can stop enemies from trying to score no matter what, almost pull them away from the ball, take the ball out of their hands. And she's also very good at helping wipe enemies. If you can kill 2 or 3 enemies at once in Brawl Ball, it makes it a lot easier to score. And she has that ability to just turn games like that. Now, Colt is also very good in Brawl Ball, specifically because he can deal so much damage at once and he can clear boxes. So he's a very good defensive brawler. He's very good at staying long range, being the last line of support, and just chipping away at people. And then once he's starting to kill enemies, it makes it a lot easier for your team to push. And at the same time, he can also clear boxes as well. Now, Barley is at number 6 because Barley is great at area control. So in Brawl Ball, a lot of times you can sort of tell where enemies are going to go, right? There's usually certain lanes where if they want to score, they have to go through those areas. Now, also, if they want to stop you, they have to go through those areas. So that's why Barley is also very good in Brawl Ball. Now, he's ranked a lot higher than Dynamike because it's so much easier to hit his shots. People are often moving very fast and moving often in Brawl Ball, and specifically with Mortis at very high and very high usage, that's one of the reasons Dynamike is much lower compared to Barley. Now, 7 at Spike is very similar to Barley as well. He deals a lot of area damage, and his super is great defensively, and he can stop people in their tracks at any time. There's a lot of clumping up as well, and you'll see specifically he's very good in a certain map, and I'll tell you what that is later on. Now, Brock is at 8. He can deal a decent amount of damage, but one of the main reasons he's at 8 is because his super is so good. It's able to clear a lot of boxes at once and kill enemies. So if you can get one or two enemies and also clear some boxes at the same time, now make sure you want to be clearing the enemy boxes, not your boxes. If you can do that, you're going to get great value, and that's one of the reasons Brock is still pretty good in Brawl Ball. Now, Bull is all the way at 9. He is the lowest tank, really. He's still useful, but he's just not nearly as good as El Primo because you can't control his super as well. He can clear boxes, but that's not really the main thing you want to be doing with him. You really want to be trying to score goals, and sometimes it can be hard to approach the goal just like Mortis and El Primo can with Bull. You can super up some, but it's hard to do it as well. You sort of have to rely on your teammates a lot more. Now, Crow is all the way at 10. Crow, one of the strongest brawlers in the game, but not quite as strong in Brawl Ball. Now, the main reason for this is he has not very much health. So one of the things in Brawl Ball is, one, there's a lot of high health brawlers. Two, they can do a lot of damage fast, and it's very close quarters as well. So it's hard for Crow to really stay alive for a long time, and you sort of have to have continuous pushes to really succeed in Brawl Ball. Now, he is pretty good on Backyard Bull, where he can really poison people, but on some of the other maps, it's hard for him to constantly poison people. He's still pretty decent, but he's not that great. And as I was saying earlier with Dynamike, he's just not as good as Barley, since it's harder for him to get as many hits, but he can clear walls well. He's still definitely a good option. I just don't think he's as good as Barley. Now, Ricochet at 12. The main reason Ricochet has really fallen in this is that he can't clear boxes, so he can deal a lot of damage. And there are some maps that there are a lot of walls where he can really make some hard-to-hit shots. But his inability to clear boxes is really a negative as a support brawler. You really want your support brawlers to be able to help clear boxes, to be able to clear up lanes in order for you to shoot and score goals. Now, Poco's at 13. Again, he can't clear boxes. He is pretty decent, though, as enemies often group up, so he can deal a decent amount of damage. And at the same time, his heal actually can make it a lot easier to score goals. You can make very sudden pushes, you can make big rushes, and he can keep you alive just long enough to score that goal sometimes. All right, now let's get into the bottom of the brawlers. So these are the brawlers I probably wouldn't use at all in Brawl Ball. I wouldn't use any of these. You can maybe use them to some success, but honestly, I just don't think it's not worth it. They're better options, and they really have a lot of weaknesses in Brawl Ball. Nita at 14 doesn't deal damage very fast. There's a lot of high health brawlers, as I was saying, so it's hard for Nita to really stop people. Nita's not very good defensively, since Nita can't deal a bunch of damage at once. Her bear is decent, but again, it's not that strong. It doesn't really take over games like it can in other game modes. Bo at 15 just doesn't deal enough damage, and he can sort of destroy walls, but it's not reliable, and you don't know when it's going to happen. So Bo just isn't strong enough overall. And Pam at 16, Pam just, again, doesn't destroy any boxes. Her healing turret is okay. If you didn't know, turrets can stop shots if it hits the turret, but that alone isn't enough to really make Pam strong enough. She can deal some damage. She has decent health, but it's just not enough. She needs to be more targeted damage, and her healing turret just is often not very useful in Brawl Ball. It doesn't last long enough, and any time a goal is scored, any of her turrets are destroyed. And same thing with Jessie. Again, just doesn't deal enough individual damage, doesn't have enough defensive capability, and then Piper as well. Just doesn't have enough damage per second, really. Is not able to be continuously dealing damage. Can deal individual damage on some maps decently. But then again, she has too low health, so she dies too easily, so she's not very good defensively in that sense. And then her super is just not very useful. It can destroy walls, but you have to get very close to the enemy. And since he has just low health, that's really not a great idea. All right, guys, those are my overall rankings. Now let's get into each individual map. Okay, so starting off on Pinhole Punt. Pinhole Punt has the most grass out of all the maps. There's a lot of places to hide, but at the same time, it is the second most boxes, not the most, like Triple Dribble. So there's a lot of places to hide overall, since there's a lot of grass and boxes, but it can become sort of long range, since while there are a lot of amount of box places, the overall amount of boxes are pretty easy to destroy. You can often destroy a lot of boxes at once, and then the map becomes pretty open. So once you destroy those middle boxes, it can be hard to hide. With Pinhole Punt, you have to be making sure that enemies aren't sneaking up on you in the middle. Oftentimes, you're going to see Bulls, Shellys, El Primos, in the middle in the grass, hiding and waiting for an opportunity to attack. There's a lot of great sneak opportunities on this map, so you have to be careful and you have to be checking the bushes constantly and making sure you're going up the map as a team. Now, another thing with this map is you can easily destroy the walls in the middle protecting the goal. Now, if you can do that, you can score a lot of long-range goals on this map, so make sure to keep your super after you've destroyed some walls to be able to shoot some long-range goals. Now, as far as what I think the best team comp is on this map, I would probably do something like a Mortis or an El Primo combined with a Shelly or a Tara, and as well with a Colt, Barley, or a Brock. Now, the Mortis and El Primo are going to be focusing on scoring goals, and your Tara and Shelly, or Tara or Shelly, is going to be focused on trying to clear boxes and just kill enemies and also be very good at defense. And your Colt, Barley, or Brock is going to want to be focusing on dealing a lot of damage and clearing boxes if they can, but mostly focusing on defense and making sure no one gets behind them. Now let's go into Triple Dribble. Triple Dribble has by far the most boxes out of any of the maps, so being able to destroy boxes is a big bonus here, as well as brawlers like Throwers. It's very easy for them to get a lot of damage since you know where people are going to go. So people like Barley, Spike, and Dynamite are definitely strong here since they can easily do a lot of damage since it's hard for the enemy to escape their shots. You're still going to want to have at least a Mortis or an El Primo, and then a Shelly or a Tara are also great options, especially Shelly since he can destroy a lot of boxes. Colt as well can destroy a good amount of boxes, same with Dynamite as well, Brock. Now for Triple Dribble, I would most definitely use a Barley or a Dynamite, and then you probably want something like a Shelly combined with maybe an El Primo since there's a lot of boxes, though Mortis is still very strong here as well. And now for Backyard Bull. Backyard Bull is by far the most open map, so long range is very strong here. There's not a lot of places to hide. And one of the main things with this map is you have the two side funnels on the far ends, and you pretty much have to go through them unless you open the middle boxes. So opening the middle boxes is very important on this map. Otherwise, you won't have many lanes to shoot from, and it's going to be obvious where you're trying to go. So make sure you have someone on your team who is able to destroy those middle boxes. So the ability to destroy boxes on this map is probably the least important out of all of the others, but you still want someone who can destroy the middle boxes at the least. I think Mortis is a little bit weaker on this map since there's a little less places for him to hide, but he's still very strong here. And Shelly and Primo are still, of course, very strong. I think Primo is probably the top offensive option on this map. If you're sort of near the goal line and you shoot it towards the middle and bounce it off the wall on the enemy side, and then you jump on the wall, open the walls up, and you grab the ball, and often that's a really great way to score on this map. Now, Colt is very strong here since he can do a lot of damage since it's so open, and he can destroy those boxes as well. Tar also strong. And then again, a lot of similar people. This is probably Crow's strongest map since it's the most open, and this is really where you can get that poison damage on this map especially. Brock is still pretty strong here. It definitely favors long range, so you're going to see Brock a little higher and Ricochet a little higher than normal. As far as team comp and Brawl Ball, you're often going to want to go with something like a Mortis or an El Primo combined with a Shelly or a Tara, and then combined with a support slash long range brawler, something like a Colt who can deal a lot of damage and destroy boxes, or a Barley who has great area control, or a Brock who can deal a decent amount of damage and destroy a lot of boxes, or a Spike who has great defense and area control. Those are all good options for your third brawler who's long range slash support. Alright everyone, so that was my Brawl Ball ranking video. I hope you enjoyed. In the next video, I will go over who the giveaway winner is. If you haven't entered the giveaway yet, you still have a chance. I'll put the link in the description. I'm doing a gameplay review giveaway. Now, for the next ranking video, I'll be doing a heist ranking. And then after that, since I'll have ranked all of the game types, I will combine my rankings and make an overall ranking. Now, I will be updating them, so it won't be the exact same rankings. But I do think it will be very interesting to see who is the top overall brawlers. All right, so thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed, and catch you next time.